Good evening, I'm Lisa Joyner, Coordinator of Student Services. Student Services is comprised of five departments: psychological services, the school counselors, PBS, school social workers, So, Student Services comprised of five departments: school social workers, psychological services, health services, school social workers, and positive behavior support. We provide a network of supports to the schools to provide academic and behavioral success by enhancing the personal, social, and well-being of students. You know, many students come to school, some of them do not have their basic needs met. They are coming from homes where they have chronic trauma, chronic poverty, and trying to meet those needs on our end. The school social workers provide that link between the home, the schools, and the families. They are the referral agencies to community. They're the referral agents to various community agencies. They offer assistance in the area of clothing, daycare, drug abuse, educational services, finances, food, family services, institutional care, providing legal care and pregnancy, shelter, and tutorial services for those families. Our school counselors provide academic and behavioral counseling for our students to meet their emotional, social, and behavioral problems. At the elementary school, identifying those students who are struggling with the basics and trying to close that gap through the response to intervention process, which many of you may know as the acronym RTI. It's a multi-tiered system of support where students who are not responding to the benchmarks in the curriculum are then referred to Tier 2, where they receive that supplemental instruction. Within that, receiving the research-based interventions and strategies for a period of time. A committee will come back and review, a team of professionals that is multidisciplinary. It may include your teachers, your administrators, your school psychologists, your school social workers, depending on the need. It may be SLPs, variety of professionals who come together as a team and determine, are those interventions and strategies working? If not, they may increase to Tier 3, a more intensive level of interventions and strategies. It would be more intensive and a little bit longer in duration. If a student is still not responding after adequate time, then that particular student may be referred for a comprehensive evaluation to determine maybe consideration for special education services to receive that. As counselors, as you get into more of the secondary level, they are starting to look at academic counseling, determining strengths of students and maybe their pathway into becoming productive citizens and their careers and so forth. As you notice, all the banners in the back of the room, the academies, hoping to spark some interest in students so that they stay in school and want to graduate and potentially move on to some type of post-secondary program, whether it is a trade school, the military, or onto a four-year college. We also have a contract with Lakeview Center. We refer students out for counseling for those who definitely have mental health needs. The district has two licensed mental health counselors that we refer for the secondary level. Students at the elementary level are typically referred out to Lakeview, where they can receive up to 7 counseling sessions. Sometimes students might need a little bit more than that, and we will extend that so that hopefully we are meeting their mental health needs so they come back to school and focus. Because as we know, students who have some type of mental health issues may not be at their best in the classroom, and hoping that we are getting them prepared for that. The school psychologists are instrumental in facilitating the RTI process for some of their schools. They provide comprehensive evaluations in response to the referrals from schools that they identify. Unfortunately, as many of you might be aware, one of our students was in a tragic accident this weekend. We provide grief counseling for the schools when we go in because they are dealing with traumatic events. Many of them deal with lots of chronic traumatic events in their home when they come to school, so we provide that as well. Another area that student services we provide is positive behavior supports, known as PBS. Since 2009, we began with three schools who were trained in positive behavior support. Coming to now, we have 27. It is the intention of the superintendent that we become a positive PBS district. However, you know, that takes time for us to train all 50-something of our schools, so each year we add a few more schools to that process. PBS is a framework that provides instructional strategies to improve behaviors of all students. It's a systems change, it focuses on that. We use strategies that it could include teaching and reinforcing school-wide behaviors, implementing effective consequences to decrease inappropriate behavior, and recognizing and rewarding those students for engaging in appropriate behavior. Some of the positive outcomes of the PBS implementation is that we are increasing student academic engaged time, increasing student social emotional skills, decreasing problem behaviors, and then creating the positive relationship between students and teachers, and also between the staff and the families. Because as research has shown, if a student has one caring relationship, that can make the difference in them being successful. Each year we have positive behavior schools who apply and have been awarded model status by the Florida PBS Project. Those awards come in the areas of bronze, silver, and gold, and each year we always have students, since we have been implementing this, we have received schools who in each of those categories. What we've also created out of student services, Terry and I co-chair the behavior assistance team. The purpose of this team is to provide immediate supports to schools that have expressed concerns of students who have undesirable behaviors. Those can be internalizing behavior or externalized behavior. Most of the time we notice the externalized behaviors because those are the ones that we outwardly see. We come in as a problem-solving team with a team of professionals, and we sit down and we look at a particular student and we try to problem solve why is this behavior happening, and lending support in determining the plan of action so that we can help